Good morning, student. Our next chapter, chapter 3, motion of the earth, rotation and revolution. Yes, earth has two motions, one rotation and revolution. Not only earth, all 8 planets have these two motions. We are going to know about these two motions and their effects. First, rotation meaning effects, revolution meaning and effects. So first, rotation. All of you know what do you mean by rotation. Rotation means when earth rotates on its own axis. So here axis word is very important. Axis. When earth rotates on its own axis. What is axis? Axis is an imaginary line passing through the center of earth, and on the basis of this line earth can rotate. But this line is not a straight line. If I draw a earth, our earth, axis like this one, it is not a straight one, and that's why due to this position with this orbital plane it forms one angle. And if I draw one perpendicular line diagram wise it is wrong, my diagram is not correct, because here angle value is 23.5 degrees and here angle value is 66.5 degrees. These two angles are same. Same means fixed, not same. These two angles are fixed. So it is clear that axis is not a straight one. It is little bit tilted and forms these two angles, one with orbital plane, another one perpendicular with a perpendicular line. This position of axis is called inclination of earth's axis. But this axis is very important. On the basis of this axis, earth can rotate. Now, its effects. Rotation has many effects. One of them, all of you know, day and night. Formation of day and night, the most important one, the formation of day and night. But except this one, few more effects we can see. Formation of tides, Coriolis force develop. This force actually help to deflect wind and ocean currents in different direction on earth. Next, you can say, due to this rotation, earth gets a specific shape, which is called oblate spheroid. Except this few, we can see this situation, dawn, dusk, and circle of illumination. These three situations also develop like day and night. What are the meaning of these three? Dawn, dusk and circle of illumination. Actually, dawn and dusk, these two are the transitional period between day and night. We can see these two situations before sunrise, dawn, and after sunset, dusk. Means light is still there. Before appearing sun, we can see the light, and after sunset we can see the light. These two situations develop due to rotation. And circle of illumination. Circle of illumination is an imaginary line which divides our earth into two halves. One lit half, another dark half. Yes, due to rotation, day and night occurs. So half of the earth gets light, half of the earth doesn't get light. So here we can see dark,
and here we can see light. So circle of illumination is an imaginary line which form dark half, or which divides our earth into two half, one dark half, another lit half. This line form due to rotation. So these are the few effects of rotation. Now the second motion, revolution, and its effects. What is the meaning of revolution? Revolution means when earth revolves around the sun on its own orbit. So here important word is orbit. That is called revolution. But when earth revolves around the sun on its own orbits, it takes time, and the time limit is, all of you know, 6 hours 48 minutes and
365 days.
Done. So this time it takes. That's why this motion has only and only one effect, and that effect is leap year. Yes. If anyone asks what are the effects of revolution, answer should be forming leap year. Only one. Forming leap year. How? Because of this duration. Every year we take 365 days to complete 1 year. But this figure is left. So all of you know the first year 1, year 2, year 3, and year 4. Every year we are getting this 6 hours. And finally, during 4th year, it converted into 24 hours, which we can add as an extra day with this last, means 4th year. And this year form leap year. Like this year, 2020, it is also a leap year. So like this way, leap year form. And this leap year form due to revolution. Because to complete one revolution, Earth takes this much time. But we are taking only first figure to indicate that our, to indicate 1 year completed means 365 days, and we are not taking this 6 hours. So after 4 years, it converted into 24 hours, and we know 24 hours means 1 day, which we can add with this 4th year. Like this way, leap year form, and this is the effect of revolution. Only one effect. But one important effect here I have mentioned, the changing season. Actually, you see the line, students, I have written here. It is a combined effect. Combined means inclination of the earth's axis and revolution. If you think revolution only responsible to form this effect, that is wrong. It is the combined one. One is inclination of earth axis. I said our earth axis is not a straight. Plus revolution. Together form this thing. Changing season. So every year we can see different seasons due to inclination of earth axis and revolution. And here I have given circle. Like last chapter, chapter 2, I have told already that circle portion means I will discuss it later, not now. So you just write this effect and give the circle, which I will discuss after opening our school. Now this is the last part of this chapter, perihelion and aphelion. And one more chapter, again I want to say, the changing season will be discussed after opening the school. Otherwise, this is the last. Perihelion and aphelion, these two are the situation developed due to this revolution.
When earth revolves around the sun, sometimes it comes close to sun, sometimes it goes far away from the sun. When it comes close to the sun, this situation is called perihelion. And when it goes far from the sun, this situation is called aphelion. In short, I am writing P here and A here. And during this time, the distance between sun and the earth is this one, 147 million kilometer. And here it is 152 million kilometer. And the specific date when we are very close to sun is 3rd January. And when we are the furthest from the sun, that is 4th July. So this situation called perihelion and aphelion, and this situation develops due to revolution of earth. Clear? So finally we have learned what we have learned from the chapter, very small chapter. We have learned rotation, revolution and their effects. These are the main things of this chapter. And one important thing, changing season, that one definitely after reopening I will say. Now your homework. Distinguish differences. You have to write about it. Very simple, very easy. Rotation and revolution. Perihelion and aphelion. Next, diagrams. Two diagrams I have given. Inclination of the earth axis and perihelion and aphelion. I have mentioned page number. You just note down. And last, define the following terms. 10 terms I have given. Maximum I have discussed. Few I didn't say. You try to write down. Otherwise, if it is not clear, you mark it. That is rotation, sidereal day, axis, circle of illumination, parallelism of the earth's axis, dawn and dusk, revolution, orbit, the midnight sun and the leap year. These 10 terms you have to define. At least you try to write this 10. And yes, copy, all of you know I prefer small size copy, but it can be ruled or practical, that is your choice. A small copy you have to use for all homeworks. Thank you.